For me, it was Earl Anthony, Mark Roth, Pete Weber. All these names are bowlers.
Bowlers?
These are all bowlers. I grew up as a kid a bowler. I didn't play football in Little League. I didn't play football until high school. So for me growing up, I was a bowler. I thought I was going to be, you know, one of the next best bowlers. So those were the guys that I watched. Being honest,
I'm just picturing all these high school coaches lining up at the bowling alley to come find Jerome Bettis.
Yeah, but I was big enough then, but I just, you know, I came from a family of bowlers. And that was what we did on the weekend. So when it was time to watch college football, I was on the lanes.
Okay, serious question. Did you have to get like a custom ball? How did your
I've been bowling since I was like 7, 6 years old. So, you know, by that time, I was one of the best bowlers in the state of Michigan. I was traveling all over the country, bowling. And
did you roll it or throw it?
I can roll it now. But what made me go into football actually was I looked at college scholarships when I was 14. I had to decide which high school I was going to go to. And so I said to myself, where can I get a scholarship for bowling? And there was only one school that offered an actual partial scholarship, and that was Ohio State. I'll never forget it. I'm saying, well, the odds of me getting that one scholarship is pretty thin. So that's what made me actually want to play football so I can get a chance to get a scholarship. So it worked out.
Mike, I feel like you have something to say.
I became a different kind of pro bowler.
I'm gonna guess, Bus, you had your own shoes. You probably had to share, did you?
No, I had my own shoes.